Time for a fish room update, YouTube. Hey YouTube, it's Brian coming at you today with an update. I'm just going to go through all of my tanks instead of separating them out for this month. So we get the full effect this time. Been a little busy and just haven't had time to do some separate videos this month. But we'll start off here with the reef. If you're new to my channel, this is a 29-gallon Core Life BioCube. Got it souped up pretty nice with a lot of custom parts and pieces. But the corals are doing nice. The only problem I'm really having in here is an outbreak of the, shouldn't say an outbreak, but to me it is. The pulsing zinnias are just growing out of control. I removed some rock the other night and cut them back, scraped it off, but it's kind of hard to go in there and just cut them all off because from what people say, they do give off a toxin that's bad for your other corals. In the process of doing that too, then I messed up the scape a little bit and some of the rocks are not the way they used to be, so it looks a little off and some of the corals are not in the right spot anymore, but at any rate, things are doing good overall. This trumpet coral right here is just growing out of hand. It's great. I'm ready to frag that soon. The torch isn't out right now. It got a little affected last night when I was taking off some of the pulsing zinnia, so the green star polyps are just out of hand. I've got three coral plugs down here that I've let them grow onto, so I'll cut them off and then glue them to the back. I don't know if you can see or not, but in the back here right now too, I've got one plug already with green star polyps on. There's a little fire shrimp. As you can see, this pulsing zinnia is just all over the place. It's even jumped. I don't know how else to say it, but you can see it right in the middle of those polys right there. And then it's down here by the NEM also. What else? I don't know, the fish have all been doing good in here. Haven't had any losses in quite a while now. Clowns do some hosting on that bubble NEM back there. Yeah, everything's doing real well. I guess I won't spend a ton of time on this because we got a bunch more tanks to go. Over in the other side of this room here is the discus tank, 150 gallon. Discus have been doing great. Haven't added any. They're just doing well. Of course, I think it's dinner time right now, so they're all up at the top. Got the tetras in here also, Serpe tetras. This guy's kind of the big boss of the tank right here. But yeah, overall, these guys are all doing well. Sticking with the basic scape with no plants, just some rocks, driftwood, and sand, pool filter sand. Alright, we'll take you downstairs now. Alright, so first off here we got Colossus. This is the flower horn. He is a Compha 9.9. Doing real well, active as always. He is in a new tank, as you can see. We can talk more about that later. But he's doing real well, growing, looking good. Yeah. Down below here is the Midas, male and female. They're doing real good. Haven't had any problems. No breeding with these guys. I don't know if they ever will. Doesn't really bother me one way or the other. But I'm really digging this guy. Real fun wet pet. Behind us here, we've still got some Redis latest grow outs. These are available for sale if anybody wants them. I sell them in groups of 10. Got enough in there for probably two groups. So let me know if you want some Redis latest. These guys, well, as you'll see later in the video with the parents, these guys are going to turn out to be stunners. So down below here, something a little new to the fish room. They're hiding right now, so I'm going to move this pot. I've got a Red Devil pair. One of three Red Devil pairs that I have right now. Picked these up from one of my local friends, Bob. Bob Randall. And the idea was I was wanting to do kind of a Red Devil community tank. Thought it would work out, and it did not work out at all. So now I've got a bunch of Red Devils on my hands that don't really know what to do with. So I've moved a few of them on, and I could probably get rid of one or two more pairs. So if you're looking for Red Devils, let me know. Up here is the Red Magma Flower Horn. He's looking real good too lately. For a long time, when I had him in that other bottom tank that we just were looking at with the Red Devils, he wasn't looking too good, but now that I have him up here, he's just looking awesome again. Full of attitude, full of color. Almost had gotten rid of this guy, but I'm pretty glad I didn't. So, he's doing well. Down here is another one of the Red Devil pairs I was talking about. They're hiding in this tube right now. I did water changes today, so maybe not the best time to do a video. Sometimes the fish tend to hide, especially newer fish in the fish room. But here's the male. Female's back there. She's gonna hide right now. Real nice, kind of creamsicle looking. Nice big lips. Over here we've got the Umbi pair, real mag Umbis. Halen and Kama. Looking real good. Real happy with this pair. Couple people recently, though, have asked me if I'd be willing to sell them. At first, I didn't think I would, but, you know, I would sell this pair if someone's willing to pay what they're worth. So if you're looking for a real nice Umbi pair, I mean, this guy's 12 inches. She's, I don't know, 8, 9 inches, something like that. He comes from Magnus and Beast, which if you know anything about Umbis, you know that that's great. And she's a wild caught. So anyway, like I say, a few people have asked me, and so the answer is yes, I would consider selling them. Up here is my Rio Blanco Motas. Got some nasty reflection going, but this male has really been growing lately. Looks like they have been scrapping a little bit. He's got some separation on his tail fin there. She's looking beautiful as always. Yeah. I think we'll have a spawn before too long with these guys. They're acting like they always act like this before they spawn, so probably in the next couple of days I'll come down and see her messing around over in the pot. You can tell she's ready too just by looking at her. Beautiful, beautiful pair. Really, really like these guys. Over here we have some real good news. The Redis latest pair spawned recently. You can tell he is worked up that I'm even anywhere near here, but there are wigglers in that pot right now. Not a ton, but there are some. You can see a little pile back there. And so yeah, that's real good news. These guys, if these make it to free swimmers, will only be the second successful spawn I've had with them. You can tell just by the coloration right now, they got their full breeding dress on. They're just beautiful, beautiful fish. That's what it's all about, really. Just to see the way they look and the way they've been acting in the last week is just kind of makes the hobby all worthwhile. That stupid glare is really ticking me off, but that's what happens when you have a bunch of tanks in one room. I've got the Sikwia in here too, and they've actually spawned a few times recently, a few different male and female pairs. You can see these guys are actually in breeding dress right now. I really dig these fish. I mean, this one right here is full-grown male, not too big at all. 5 inches probably. What I'm gonna do is take these guys out of here and put them in a 75 and make a nice little setup for them and just kind of let them do their thing. Really, I wasn't wanting to keep them, and so I just put them in here as dithers, target fish, whatever you want to say. And I've come to really like them, especially when they're all colored up like this. So, and I've still got two sets of grow-outs from them, so I'll throw those in with the colony, or not colony, but group, and just let things happen. I mean, if anyone does want to get some Sikwia, they're not a super popular fish, but man, they sure look nice when they're set up. Let me know and we can work something out. But yeah, I'm really digging this guy right here. So there are two kind of pairs, really. These are the two males, two females, and then there's a couple oddball ones. And they just kind of do their thing. There's one of the females back here. She kind of hangs out back here. She had free swimmers back there about 2 weeks ago, and they didn't make it. Probably between the Isleitas and the other Sikwia, they got chowed on, I'm sure. But at any rate, let's try to get one more close-up of this bad boy. And he's looking nice right now. All right, down below, we've got the Haitiensis. I've gotten in some more Haitiensis, and then I got rid of some. You can see male and female right here. In this tank, this is the big male. There are 6 total in this tank. Some like to hide, some are out. You know, kind of how Haitiensis do at that size. And then my other ones are up here. It's another big male. And then there's 2 females in here. At least 1 female, and I'm not sure if the other's a male or female, but this guy likes to hide in his tube right here. I don't know if you're seeing that or not. I'm holding the camera up because this tank's up high. Not sure where the other ones are right now, but like I said before too, I did water changes today, so some of the fish are a little skittish. But I'm really impressed with some of these Haitiensis I got. And I won't be keeping them all, but for now I am. I moved some of my other ones on just last weekend, shipped them out to a few different people. But yeah, as you can see right here, this is my final Red Devil pair, and these are the ones I'll keep for sure, at least for now. This is their second spawn in less than 2 months since I've had them. Really, really like this male and the deep orange in his kind of head. I wish his whole body was like that, but I'm still happy with him. These guys are just throwing out spawns like clockwork every 3 weeks. Doing real good. You can see hundreds of them right there. And then, just for the heck of it, I pulled some from my last, for the from the first spawn that they had when I first got them. They're up here. We'll just see what happens. Alright, so we'll take a look at the shrimp tanks that we've got down here right now. So this is the Crystal Red, the A through S grade. As always, they are just doing phenomenal, breeding like crazy. There's a buried female right in front of you there. Looking good. But tons of shrimp in the tank. You can see them all over. Babies all over the place. So it's always a good sign. All different sizes of from adults to the smallest of babies and everyone in between. So these just breed like crazy, and got a lot of people that are always looking for them from me. So these are always available for sale if anyone's looking. So let me know. Next door here we have got. So what I did in this tank was I took a couple of PRL. Pure Red Line Crystal Reds and some a couple of Royal Blue Tigers and mixed them to try to get some Thai bees, and I did. There's some Thai bees in here. Let me see if I can find a couple. There's a couple in this shot, at least one in the middle there. There's another one that just came into the frame, and then the rest are just these Crystal Red Mischlings, which also look nice. But I've got one generation, I shouldn't say one generation, but I've had babies once, and then just recently, like this week or last week, another set of babies. You can see this really small one over there by the snail on the leaf. Most of them are still kind of in hiding, but every so often I see a few of the newer babies out and about. I expect them to be out in the next week or two, quite a bit more. And then the one PRL female, you can't really see her that good right now. She's hiding in that subwasser tank, but she's buried again. So that's good news. We'll have another group of these. I'm really excited to see, too, what when these get old enough to start breeding, what they'll kick out. Kind of the second generation of them. So just a good close-up of one of the Thai bees. Another Thai bee in the middle there. One on the leaf right there. So, that's what's going on in that tank. Next door here, we've got some more Crystal Reds. These, I can't remember in my last video if I talked about these, but these came from my buddy Carl. He had what he thought were some PRLs, and then when he found out that they weren't, he decided to sell off some of them, so I bought these. They're real nice quality Crystal Reds. There are at least one, maybe two buried females in this group right now. I can't seem to locate any of them, but I just saw them last night, actually. So these guys are going to be breeding, too, so that's cool. Seem to be doing real well. Next door here are my Pure Red Lines, PRLs. Don't have the greatest of news to report on these. The colony just seems to be dwindling, and I'm not really seeing much breeding. I gotta figure out what's going on and jumpstart that. The ones I have, though, are great quality, and you can see they're active and swimming around and stuff. Still keeping up hope for these guys. There's a lot of cover in here too with the plants, so not as many of them are out all the time. I'm going to go get in there and really hack off this mini Pellia and maybe do something with that big crypt in the back there. But so that should allow me to start seeing a few more of these guys. But this colony just hasn't done what I had hoped it would do, but I'm going to continue to work with it and keep my fingers crossed. So. Fun to watch these guys swim around too. You know, and when the shrimp are actually swimming around like this, I've been told that that's a really good sign. It's almost kind of like a mating dance versus them just being on the substrate crawling around. So Whether or not that's true, I don't know, but I'm going to take it as a good sign. Over here are one of my Taiwan bee tanks. I've had a little bit better success with some of the babies' survival rate compared to what I've had in the past. So that's a good sign. A couple really small babies right there. So I'm going to keep continuing to work on this colony and hope that it'll finally grow out at some point. I just haven't had the luck that I had hoped for with the Taiwan bees, but I'm going to continue to work with them. It just doesn't seem like the baby survival rate's very good, although it seems to be a little bit better. They seem to be growing past the stage that they have for me in the past, so that could be a good sign. So, these two right here, these two blue bolts, that's about the biggest I have ever seen to get babies, but now I've gotten some that are getting bigger, that blue bolt up there and some other ones. So, this shadow panda has grown to a fairly good size, so gonna continue to work and hope and see what happens. There's a wine red right here too, real quick, see if I can zoom in on her. No. Down below, this Taiwan bee colony, not quite the quality as the ones up above, but I finally got some breeding going and with these guys. I got some, I don't know if you want to call them red bolts or goldens or just bolts or pink bolts or whatever. They don't have the most brightest red color in them, but they do have some reddish color, some of them. Some of them don't, like this one right here is pretty much pure white. But they've had some babies, and they're pretty much throwing off white colored. I've got some blue bolts in fairly recently. I don't know if they're in my last video. There's some of them in there. They haven't bred yet, but they seem to be doing decent. So we're continuing to watch them. Came from a really good line from my buddy Carl. So yeah, there's a baby blue bolt. Anyway, we'll continue to see. Oh, there's a little baby panda, shadow panda, whatever you want to call it. So there's some promise in this tank. Take you over here. These are the reds. I guess high grade cherry, you want to call them. At one point, people were calling these savage reds from a hobbyist that's no longer in the hobby. Just have a handful left, but I do have, I think, two buried females in here now. I think one of them's in the shot right there. It's kind of hard to tell through the viewfinder. So, keeping my fingers crossed that things will work out and I can start to replenish this colony. Royal Blue Tigers are doing great as always. I've sold a ton of them lately, so I'm kind of holding off on sales now for a while, just so that I don't get too low on my population and end up losing the colony. So, gonna reproduce for a while and then we'll have them available again soon. Down here, painted fire reds. Just a handful left, although there's a buried female right on that filter there. And I saw a few babies last night in here too, so there's hope. I had lost pretty almost this entire colony and then all of the tigers that I had in here. Not sure what happened, but so we're gonna we will rebuild, as they say. Crystal blacks down here. I had sold off some of these and ended up not paying attention and got a little low on the count, so I ordered 20 more. So I've just recently added some to this colony, and we'll see how that goes. Hopefully we'll get some breeding going on soon here and get that colony back up and looking good. Down below here are the Aura Blue Tigers. They're doing good. I think in my last video I showed this, but I had three or four buried females and I've never seen babies. Don't know if they're still hiding, and I'll see them at some point. I'll continue to keep my eyes open. But I'm assuming at this point, because it's been about a month now, that nothing's going to happen and we lost those babies. But we'll wait and see. You never know. Their color isn't the greatest because they're on a light substrate instead of dark. I'm going to work on switching that out at some point here. All right, up above here are the green jades. Kind of hard to really see these guys. But they're looking good. They still continue to breed for me, so that's nice. That is a buried female right there. Yeah, so they're doing good. And then up here in what used to be my red tiger tank, now there's just a few miscellaneous red lilies. They've been having babies. I don't know what I'm going to do. I don't really want to grow another red lily colony, so I'm going to probably, once I decide to put something else in this tank, get rid of all the lilies. But that is a buried mama right there. You can see some babies in here. I don't know. Sorry, I lost my train of thought there as I was looking at that shrimp. But a bunch of algae in here too. But yeah, you know, I don't know. They're doing okay. There's babies on this filter right back there. I don't know if you can see because of that glare. But and then finally up here are the blue dreams. I had kind of one colony going and didn't turn out to be much. I pretty much lost them all, so I recently ordered some more. There's 10 new ones in here. I've got two buried females right now in there, so that's good. There's one of them right in front of you. I don't know if the other one's there or hiding out somewhere else, but so we will kind of see how that works. I did last night find one baby in here, which I'm assuming, and it wasn't quite a baby, it was starting to grow a little bit. So I'm assuming it must have been from that last colony I had, kind of a lone survivor, because there were some babies in that last colony. So we'll continue to see what happens. But I really liking the color in these, and I'm thinking about getting some more to add to this colony too from a different bloodline. So that's that. All right, we'll go upstairs now. So here we are in the office, and probably somebody that you guys were wondering where the heck he was when I first went downstairs. This is the most asked about fish right now, and he's been in that 90 gallon at the bottom of the stairs for a long time, but I brought him up into the office now. This guy's my favorite fish, and I decided to get rid of my Giardini that was in this tank, so I figure what the heck, we'll bring Cheeto up here so he can hang out with me all day while I work in the office. And then I've got some additional clown loaches in here now. I'm up to 15. I bought some off my buddy Mike Mann, and he was getting rid of his, so. And then there's just a barred red devil in here as well. But yeah, Cheeto's doing great. It's fun to have him up here in my office while I'm working. And yeah, this guy's just like a dog in water. Pretty cool fish. Not much more I can say about him that I don't already say in every video, but anyway, these loaches are awesome too. I got a couple of them that I got are bigger than the ones I had already, so it's pretty fun. Pretty fun tank. The 90 gallon over here is doing good. This is, I don't remember if in my last video if I had all these cherry shrimp in here, but I've got about at least 200 red cherries, and some of them are paint of fire red quality. They're doing really good. Bought them off my buddy Carl, and then we've got the Amanos in here, and I've got some Cardinal Tetras, which I'm going to probably get rid of. I'd bought them when I had decided that the crystal reds weren't going to work out in here, and then I decided to give the cherries a try, and they're doing just fine. So think I'm going to get rid of the fish just so that these shrimp can breed without the fish eating the babies. And they will. I mean, these tetras will come right in when there's a group of shrimp eating a piece of food or something in a big group. They'll come in there and just try to eat the food from them. So here's some really nice colored ones up on this stone here. Some of the quality in these are really good. This is a really good line from what I understand, so. The Monte Carlo's doing decent. I'd cut out some in the back here, sold it to some people that needed some, and it doesn't seem to want to grow back there, so I'm not sure what that's all about. I'm just gonna be patient though. I've been having some algae problems in here, both with algae on the glass and then this kind of weird type hair algae stuff. You can see it on the fissidens right there, kind of sticking off the top. I'm not sure what it's called, but there's some right here. If you can, it gets like kind of weird and branchy almost. If anyone knows what that's called, let me know. There's some more of it back there, but within a week's time between water changes, it really grows heavy in here, so I'm not sure what I need to do to adjust this. You can see it's purling a little bit, but not as much as I'd like it to. So I think I need to turn up the CO2 a little bit, but for the most part, things are doing really good in this tank. Kind of cool to have all these red shrimp in here. Down below here is the yellow Neo tank. I lost a bunch of them because I had a heater malfunction, but some of them did survive, and I recently got 10 in from somebody online, and then I've got another 20 or so coming here next week, so I'm going to try to jumpstart that colony and see where it goes. This tank up here is just kind of my... Sorry, the video cut off there. So this tank up here is just kind of my coal tank. I just throw in different, there's a red lily, there's some kind of a Neo. I can't remember what tank I pulled it out of, but as you can see, she's actually buried, so we'll see what happens there. there's some various different ones. There's a molt on that leaf there, and there's another shrimp over there. Couple of rillies, so various stuff. I'm having a heck of a time with this sponge filter here. Keeping it going there. Moved it around a little. Final tank up here is the Tangerine Tigers. They're doing good. I recently got another batch of 10 from a guy. And I also recently saw some babies in here, so that's great news. I'm hoping to really jumpstart this colony too and get a lot of these. I did install in this tank too one of those Hamburg Matten filters that Rob at Flip Aquatics builds and sells. And that's been really increasing the flow in here. I don't know if you can see it at this angle, but... And that reminds me too, one big thing that I didn't talk about when we were downstairs before is that I recently, I'm gonna turn the light on this tin, went over to an air system, if you couldn't tell when we were looking at all the tanks with all the sponge filters going. There's the Pondmaster 1000 up here. And you can see the PVC pipe going all the way around up here and then over here, all the way over to the shrimp tanks. That was a fun build. Hadn't done anything like that before. Got some pointers from my buddy Mike Mann, and he sold me a lot of the leftover materials he had from when he had to take down his one air system at his house. First at his old house and build the one in the new house, and then he sold me his extra pump here too, so that was nice of him. That's awesome. But so far I'm digging it. I've got my canisters and my hang on the back still going until these filters, the sponge filters, seed themselves. Depending on the tank size, you know, I've got 5 and all my 125s. I think I got 6 down here in the 180, 2 in each 75. And then I added, you know, these little dual sponge filters that I use in my shrimp tanks. I added one to each tank too. So that's really going to help with the electric bill once I take down all these canister filters and stuff. So that'll be great. I'm getting used to the noise. It's a lot more noise, you know, all the bubbling from the air filters, sponge filters, I should say. But, you know, it is what it is. So, but yeah, for now, that's about all I've got for you guys. We'll leave you with Colossus here. If you're new to this channel, make sure you do subscribe. I like to do regular update videos and some other mixed in videos as well on my fish tanks. I'd love to have you as a subscriber. Make sure you go down below to all the members of Team Aquatic Support and subscribe to their YouTube channels as well. And make sure you go check out Aquatic Support Systems on Facebook and check out the Facebook group called Aquatic Support Community. A great group to get knowledge and talk about fish, show off your fish, all that kind of stuff. So until next time, thanks for watching.